Now let us see top 50 SQL interview questions and answers. The first one is, what is DBMS? We'll take this database and database management part also, and then we'll talk about the SQL also. So what is DBMS, database management system? A DBMS is a set of program or is a collection of program that controls, create, maintain and usage of database. So this is a program that controls the creation, maintenance and usage of the database. DBMS can be termed as a file manager that manages data in database rather than saving it in a file system. So it saves in certain database or a certain framework or arrangement, not just in a file system. What is RDBMS, Relational Database Management System? RDBMS stands for Relational Database Management System. RDBMS stores the data into collection of tables. See, what I was talking about here, the DBMS can be termed as file manager that manages data in a database. So this database here in RDBMS is tables. Okay. And as I suggested, the DBMS also controls the creation, maintenance and usage of database. So in this RDBMS also, RDBMS store the data in the collection of, in the form of collection of tables, which is related by common fields between the columns of the table. So it also provides relational operators to manipulate the data stored into the table. So relational calculus, it uses, RDBMS uses the relational calculus, that is the mathematics behind RDBMS, to work on with the queries or the modifications or the actions on the database. For example, this SQL Server is RDBMS. What is SQL now? SQL is a structured query language. You know, you need to communicate with the database. How you are going to communicate with the database? For that, we have SQL. So this is a standard language, NC standard language, used to perform tasks such as retrieval, update, insertion, deletion of data from a database. As standard SQL commands, they are select. Okay, select from where all these commands are there. So SQL is DML also, DDL also. DML means data definition language. DML means data manipulation language. So it creates also and it modifies also. What is a database now? Database is nothing but an organized form of data for easy access. You know, if you are able to organize the data in such a way that you are able to access them, store, retrieve and manage the data easily, this is a database. So this is also known as the structured form of data, which can be accessed in many ways, like school management database, bank management database. What are tables and fields now? What are tables and fields? You know, when you're talking about this RDBMS, the data is organized in the form of tables. So table has what? Table has rows and table has column. We have rows, you have columns. So the table is a set of data that are organized in a model with columns and rows. So columns, these columns can be categorized as vertical and rows are horizontal. So table has specified number of columns called the fields, but it can have any number of rows, which is called the record. For example, table can be employee, the field can be employee ID, employee name, you know, date of birth. Data can be for employee ID. This is the data, employee name is David, date of birth is 11/15/1960. What is a primary key? What is a primary key? Primary key, let me tell you in a layman language, for a table or in a table, if you are trying to find out a particular record, is a tuple. Tuple means a single row in a table. So if you want to find a single row uniquely, if some column is there which can uniquely identify that particular row, then we call that column as the primary key. So a primary key is a combination of field which uniquely specify a row. This is a special kind of unique key and it has implicit not null. So you cannot have a column, that column cannot contain the null values because it is primary key. So it is there to identify a row. It means the primary key values cannot be null. What is a unique key? Unique key. A unique key constraint uniquely identified to identify each record in the database. So this provides uniqueness for the column or set of columns. A primary key constraint has automatic unique constraint defined on it. Okay, you don't have to specify it, but not in case of unique key, you have to specify it. So unique key constraint uniquely identify each record in the database, which will provide the uniqueness for the column or set of columns. So there can be many unique constraints defined per table, but only one primary key constraint defined per table, only one primary key. There can be many unique keys. What is a foreign key? Foreign key means if there are two tables, one table has a primary key and in the second table that column is also there, then you call in second table it as a foreign key, because the key or the column which is primary key of some other table, in that table we will call that, okay, this column is a foreign key because it is a primary key of some other table. Let me explain you. A foreign key is one table or a column which can be related to the primary key of another table. So relationship needs to be created between two tables by, we use referential integrity here, so referencing foreign key with the primary key of another table. So what it does is, let me tell you, if this is a table, this is another table, now this is a column, this is the primary key of this table, this is a column, say social security number or Aadhaar number, Aadhaar card number, this is your primary key. Now this Aadhaar card number is present here also, somewhere here, okay. And for this table this is primary key, but for this table this is not primary key, it has some other number as a primary key. But in this table this key or this column which is the primary key of this table will be called here as the foreign key. This is the only example. So what is the differential integrity? Why foreign key is needed? Foreign key is needed because you cannot delete any data from here because it is referenced to the primary key, because this is the primary key. If you delete it from here, because this is a primary key of this table, this is uniquely identifying, so you cannot delete it. So if you are trying to delete it by some mistake, you want to by any means you want to delete it, it will not be deleted because it is referentially integrated with this primary key. What is a join? When you combine two tables, that is join. So this is a cover. This is a keyword used to query table from more tables, because it is seldom that you only query from one table. The query will come from various tables. The various table has to be combined, so that combination is called the join. So this is a keyword used to query data from more tables based on the relationship between the fields of the table. Field, I am talking about the columns that are the attributes. So keys play major role when joins are used. What are the types of join and explain it? You have various join, outer join, inner join, and we'll see the other one. So there are various types of join which can be used to retrieve data, and it depends on the relationship between the table. First you have inner join. Inner join returns rows where there is at least one match of rows between the tables. Right join. Right join returns rows which are common between the tables, and all rows of right hand side table. This is the right join. Simply it returns all the rows from the right hand side table even though there are no matches in the left hand side table. What about left join? Left join returns rows which are common between the tables and are all rows of left hand side table. That is why it is left join. Simply it returns all the rows from the left hand side table even though there are no matches in the right hand side table. What about full join? Full join returns row when there are matching rows in any one of the tables. So this means that it returns all the rows from the left hand side table and all the rows from the right hand side table. This is also termed as natural join or full join. So what is normalization? In layman terms, normalization is breaking of table, or decomposition of the data into more number of tables to satisfy certain properties. So normalization is a process of minimizing the dependency and dependency by organizing fields and tables of a database. So the main aim of normalization is to add, delete, or modify a field that can be made in a single table. What is denormalization? Opposite of normalization. So denormalization is a technique used to access the data from higher to lower normal forms of database. So it is a process of combining tables to make more tables. So it is also a process of introducing the redundancy into a table by incorporating data from the related tables. What are all the different types of normalization? So how many types of normalizations are there? And this is the question. So normal forms can be divided into five forms. And the first normal form, 1NF, 2NF, and so on and so forth. So we'll see all of these. First normal form, so this should remove all the duplicate columns from the table. That is the fields we were talking. All the duplicacy of the columns should not be there. So creation of table for the related data and identification of the unique columns should be there. Second norm means redundancy there is no redundancy in 1LF. Second normal form is meeting all requirements of the first normal form and placing the subsets of data in separate tables and creating a relationship between the tables using the primary keys. Okay, tables with the primary key relationship. 3NF means, again, it should be in 2NF, but removing the columns which are not dependent on primary key constraints. Just remove that, those tables, those columns. 3NF, again, meeting all the, this is 4NF, sorry. Meeting all the requirements of this 3NF, and it should not have a multi-value dependency. 4NF and 5NF, they are based on, they are talking about the multi-value dependency. What is a view? What is a view? View means at the instance, a schema is a view. So view is a virtual table which consists of subsets of data contained in a table. So views are not virtually present. It takes less space to store. View can have data of one or more tables combined, and it is depending on the relationship. So view is not there in actual storage, right? What is an index? You have a book, so you need an index to find out, go to a specific topic. So index is like that only. Index is a performance tuning method for allowing faster retrieval of records from the table. So index is used for faster retrieval of the data records from the table. And an index creates an entry of each value, and it will be faster to retrieve the data using the index. Question is, what are all the different types of indexes? So there are three types of indexes. First is unique index. This indexing does not allow the field to have duplicate values if the column is unique indexed. The unique index can be applied automatically when the primary key is defined. Then comes the clustered index. So this type of index reorders the physical order of the table and searching is based on the key value. So each table can have only one clustered index. Then non-clustered index. Non-clustered index does not alter the physical order of the table and maintains the logical order of the data. So each table can have this number of non-clustered indexes. What is a cursor? A database cursor is a control which enables traversal over the rows or columns in the table. If you want to traverse through the different rows, same way you traverse on your tree or in a sequential search. So you want to use some or the other thing, that is, if you want to loop around, you use for I equal to 0, I less than some value. So I is that variable, that is the cursor here. So database cursor is a control which enable traversal over the rows or column records in the table, rows and records only. So this can be used as a pointer to one row in a set of rows. So cursor is very much useful for traversing, such as retrieval, addition and removal of database records. What is relationship and what are they? Relationship is defined as the connection between the tables in a database. So there are various database relationship, and these are one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-one, self-referencing relationship. Next question is, what is query? Query, see, in layman language, these are the set of instructions. Query I is set of instruction which satisfies certain condition. Okay, so a DB query or database query is a code written in order to get the information back from the database. Information you want to get the information, what you're going to say, you'll write some instructions. So query can be designed in such a way that it matched with our expectation of the result set. Simply, a question to the database is a query. What is a swap query? Query inside your query. So a subquery is query within another query. The outer query is called the main query, and the inner query is called the subquery. So subquery is always executed first, and the result of the subquery is passed onto the main query. What are the types of subquery? There are two types of subquery. They may be correlated or non-correlated. So a correlated subquery cannot be considered as independent query, but it can refer to a column in a table listed in the from the list of the main query. While the non-correlated subquery can be considered as independent query, this cannot be considered. Correlated cannot be considered. Non-correlated can be considered as independent query, and the output of this subquery are just substituted in the main query. What is a stored procedure? These are certain instructions, they are kept to run at a particular point. So stored procedure is a function consists of many SQL statements to access the database system. So several SQL statements are consolidated into a stored procedure, and they are executed them whenever or wherever required. What is a trigger? Trigger, just in the normal normal life, we say your teacher says day after tomorrow you'll have an exam. So that is a trigger that you will start studying right now. You'll go to your house and just prepare yourself for the exam. This is a trigger. So a DB trigger, database trigger, is a code of programs that will execute automatically with response to some event on a table or a view in database. So many trigger helps to maintain the integrity of the database. Now, if an account does not is not allowed to go lower than say 1,000, say some dollar or rupees or something. So if you are trying to put or make the value or put the amount below or lower than 1,000, doing some transaction so that the amount goes lower than 1,000, then a trigger will be. So the example is when a new student is added to student database, new records should be created in the related tables like exams, scoring, attendance table. What is the difference between a delete and a truncate? Delete means removing, removing all. Truncate means just removing some part. A delete command is used to remove rows from the table, where clause can be used for conditional set of parameters. Commit and rollback can be performed after delete statement. But truncate removes all rows from the table. Truncate operation cannot be rolled back. So let me change my sentences, because truncate as a word means that what I said, but here in database it is not like that. Truncate means remove all the rows. Here delete means remove rows from the table, right? What are local and global variables and their differences? Local variables are the variables which can be used or they exist inside the function. They are not known to the other function, and those variables cannot be referred to or used. Variables cannot be created whenever that function is called. Variables can be created whenever that function is called. Global variables are the variables which can be used or they exist throughout the program. Everybody can use it. Some global variable declared in global cannot be used in functions. There are this possibility also. So global variables cannot be created whenever the function is called. It is already there. So we have taken a few questions on database in SQL. We'll be taking one more session of this. Thank you so much. Take care.